Did you know that the first report of an appendectomy came from Amyon, a surgeon of the English army who performed an appendectomy in 1735 without anesthesia to remove a perforated appendix? Hi viewers, and welcome back to Bestie. Although appendicitis has decreased in recent years, it remains one of the more common surgical emergencies. In fact, by the year 2019, the annual incidence of appendicitis was 10 cases per 100,000 population, or 7% of the US population. Appendectomy remains the most common procedure for treating appendicitis, and in today's video, we'll tell you everything you need to know about appendectomies. From recovery time, complication, risks involved, to precautions to be taken, and more. Watch until the end to find out all of them. Number 1. What exactly is appendectomy? Your appendix is a narrow, finger-shaped organ located in the lower right-hand side of your belly. It's connected to the large intestine and has little to no function in your body. When your appendix becomes swollen, it needs to be removed. An appendectomy is usually an emergency operation done to prevent the serious health problems that can happen if an inflamed or infected appendix ruptures. A rupture is a break or tear in the appendix. If an infected appendix breaks open, infection or bowel movement may spread inside the belly. This can cause a life-threatening infection called peritonitis. It's important to remove the appendix before the appendix ruptures. If the appendix is ruptured, you may have an infected sore near the place where it ruptured. You'll need to have a special kind of x-ray called a computed tomography, or CT, to help find the abscess. Once the infection or inflammation are under control, surgery will be done to remove what is left of the ruptured appendix. Number 2. How can you prepare for an appendectomy? Usually an appendectomy is an emergency procedure and there's no time to prepare. If you do have time to prepare before the surgery, there are a few things you should keep in mind. First, find someone to drive you home after the surgery. Plan for your care and recovery time after operation. Allow for time to rest. Try to find people to help with your day-to-day duties while you recover. You should also try not to smoke before and after the procedure. Smokers heal more slowly after surgery and are more likely to have breathing problems during surgery. Secondly, before your surgery, stop taking any blood-thinning medications you may have been taking. The night before the procedure, eat a light meal such as a soup and a salad. Do not eat or drink anything after midnight and the morning before the procedure. Don't even drink coffee, tea, or water. Follow any other instructions your provider gives you. Number 3. What happens during the procedure? You'll be given a general anesthetic. A general anesthetic will relax your muscles and put you to sleep. It'll keep you from feeling pain during the operation. The appendix may be removed with either open surgery or laparoscopic surgery. If you have open surgery, your surgeon will make a cut 2 to 3 inches long in your abdomen, remove the appendix, and close the wound. If you have laparoscopic surgery, instead of a cut 2 to 3 inches long, the surgeon will make a very small cut in your belly. The surgeon will put a tiny camera and tools through the small cut to remove the appendix. Then we'll close the cuts in your belly with stitches. Sometimes appendectomy is done using a combination of procedure types. In rare cases, a surgeon might start with the laparoscopic procedure but change to an open procedure during surgery. This can happen when the surgeon has trouble finding the appendix with the laparoscope, or previous surgeries might have left the patient with abdominal scar tissue that makes it difficult to remove the appendix through the laparoscopy. If this happens, the surgeon will either close up the small incisions and immediately begin the open appendectomy or end the surgery and reschedule the appendectomy. Keep in mind, if you have laparoscopic surgery instead of open surgery, you'll have less pain after the surgery. There is also a lower risk of complications from the surgery, and you'll recover from the operation faster. Number 4. What would happen once the surgery is done? When the appendectomy is over, you'll be observed for several hours before being released from the hospital. Your vital signs, such as your breathing and heart rate, will be monitored closely. The timing of your release will depend on your overall physical condition, the type of appendectomy performed, and your body's reaction to the surgery. In some cases, you may have to remain in the hospital overnight. You may be able to go home the same day as your surgery if your appendicitis wasn't severe. A family member or friend will need to drive you home if you receive general anesthesia. The effects of general anesthesia usually take several hours to wear off, so it can be unsafe to drive after the procedure. Number 5. Will you be in pain? Yes, you will feel some pain after surgery. Pain at the incision sites and in your abdomen is common. You might also have pain in your shoulders. This is from the carbon dioxide put in your abdomen during the operation. The shoulder pain should go away in 24 to 48 hours. You can take non-prescription medications to relieve the pain, unless your doctor tells you not to take over-the-counter medications. Putting ice on your incisions can also help. Be sure to ask your doctor or nurse about the correct way to use ice. Your surgeon might prescribe a small amount of narcotic pain medication to help you with the pain. Many people recover from surgery without taking any narcotic pain medication, but some will need narcotics for a few days. You might feel sick to your stomach, nauseated, or even throw up after surgery. Having surgery and anesthesia can make this happen. You'll feel better in a day or two. Tell your doctor or nurse if you keep vomiting or feel nauseated for more than 2 days. Number 6. What's the recovery time for an appendectomy? Recovery from an appendectomy is similar to other operations. You'll be allowed to eat when your stomach and intestines begin functioning properly. Usually the first meal will be clear liquid diet, broth, juice, soda pop, and gelatin. If you can tolerate this meal, the next meal usually will be a regular diet. You can expect to leave the hospital 1 or 2 days after surgery and fully recover from the appendectomy after a few weeks. Some laparoscopic procedures are done on an outpatient basis. Your doctor will likely give you medication for the pain, such as morphine or oxycodone. You'll be advised not to lift heavy objects or participate in strenuous activity for 3 to 5 days after a laparoscopic appendectomy, or for 10 to 14 days after an open appendectomy. To reduce pain, support your abdomen with a pillow or soft object when you cough, laugh, sneeze, or make any other abdominal movements. You'll probably be able to go back to work in 1 to 3 weeks. If you had open surgery, it may take 3 to 4 weeks. Number 7. What precautions should you take after the surgery? It's very important that you take a few precautions after the surgery to avoid any complications. Don't fight sleep, as your body needs rest to heal. Always wash your hands before and after touching your incision area. You should also avoid baths until your stitches or Steri-Strips are removed. Make sure not to wear tight or rough clothing. Try to use engaging activities such as music or games to distract you from your pain. Finally, return to work or school when you feel ready. Number 8. What are the risks involved? Certain risks are presented with any operation performed under general anesthesia and the abdominal cavity is opened. The first one is pneumonia and collapse of the small airways. Patients who smoke are at a greater risk for developing these complications. Inflammation of the veins is another complication but is rare. Bleeding can also occur, but rarely is a blood transfusion required. Secondly, adhesions are also a known complication of appendectomy. These adhesions can lead to intestinal obstruction that prevents the normal flow of intestinal contents. Hernia can also be a complication of any incision. However, they are rarely seen after an appendectomy because the abdominal wall is very strong in the area of standard appendectomy incision. The overall complication rate of an appendectomy depends upon the status of the appendix at the time it is removed. If the appendix has not ruptured, the complication rate is only about 3%. However, if the appendix has ruptured, the complication rate rises to almost 59%. Wound infections do occur and are more common if the appendicitis was severe, far advanced, or ruptured. An abscess may also form in the abdomen as a complication of appendicitis. Number 9. Will there be any long-term consequences of removing the appendix? For most individuals, there are no long-term consequences from removing the appendix. However, some individuals may have an increased risk of developing an incisional hernia, stump appendicitis, which are infections due to the retained portion of the appendix, and bowel obstruction. Have you or any of your loved ones gotten an appendectomy? What is an open surgery? What is laparoscopic? Let us know in the comment section below.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.